Let us pray.
A great God in heaven, we thank you for the plan of redemption.
We
thank you for the great love you have manifested towards us that were lost, dead in sin, almost irredeemable because of our evil ways.
Yet you
have paid the greatest price for our redemption. And we thank you because you have also given us the word to inform us that we do not need to die in our sins. Our redemption price has been paid.
Asidupe lowo yin tori pe isele to fun wa ni oro na eti o mo da wa loju wi pe ko ye ki a ku ninu ese wa tori pe e ti se ise irapada wa pari.
We thank you for the Lord Jesus Christ, your only begotten Son, who came to die for us.
Adupe lowo yin fun Jesu Kristi Oluwa wa omo bibi yin kan so to wa lati ku fun wa.
We thank you for the efficacy in the blood of Jesus.
And
we pray, O Lord, that as many as have not known this power, efficacy in the blood of the Lamb, you open our eyes of faith, so we'll be able to appropriate what you have done for us on Calvary, and everyone will be cleansed in Jesus' name.
Oluwa angbadra fun gbogbo awon ti a o ti laloju lati ri agbara ti irapada ti iwenumo to nbe ninu eje Jesu ipe nipase oro yin lale yi e o la wa loju a o si le mo agbara yi ti nbe ninu eje Jesu ni oruko Jesu.
We're praying that you will help us too to be able to help other people.
Asingbadra ipe ki e ran wa lowo ki awa pelu ka le ja si iranwo fun awon elomiran.
Strengthen us as we study your word.
E so wa de alagbara bi a tin keko ninu oro.
Increase our faith in you. Let all the privileges we have in the kingdom be ours to enjoy in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. We come once again to study the word of God together. As I have always mentioned to you, the Bible study is very important for you as an individual, for you as a believer. As believers, it is the word of God that confirms our faith in the Lord and makes us to grow in the
Lord.
Not only that, it equips us to be able to help other people in the way of the
Lord.
There is something you would have noticed in our Bible study every week here, that it is systematic. We pick a book and we go from chapter to chapter, from verse to verse.
Number
one, we do that because that is the way the word, the Bible, was written. We study it in the way it was written.
Akoko ohun to fa saba bi ta fin se be ni wi pe bi a se beli gan funra eniyan iyen ni pe ako ni ese li ese lori ara won be.
And you see, if the writing has gone from chapter 1 to 2 to 3 to the end, if you're studying that same way, you are following the trend in which the word was given by inspiration.
Ori wi pe ori kan yo be lati ori kini titi de ori ti o pari.
Also, the advantage is that you cannot be deceived when you study through from chapter 1 to chapter 2 to chapter 3 without omitting anything. Because if the church had been practicing something contrary to the word of God, as you go through verse by verse, you will see the verse by verse study of the word of God will show you that your church is not following the word of God.
Idakeje ewe, ohun to fa sababi ta fin keko be ni wipe nigbati a ba nkeko yen lati ori de ori kan eleko ni je ki a re oje nigba ku gba ti a ba ri awon ijo le ti won o fi gbogbo gba do lori eko ro Olorun yen ni pe nigba ta ba nkeko yi ti ki se pe boya a fi kan sile a o keko nu e ka tun fo fere sibomi nigba to je pe lese li ese la nkeko yi yo ran o lowo lati le tete mo iru awon ti won ba ti yegere kuro na oro Olorun.
It gives you assurance that you are studying the truth, that you know the truth as we go systematically, because nothing is omitted, nothing is misinterpreted. We read it, we explain it, we apply it, and the Spirit of God bears witness in your heart that as we have read, so we have explained, and then you are able to pray and you grow in the Lord. This kind of study also makes us to have balanced diet on feeding on the word of God. It's not just somebody going to the scripture and choosing what he wants and choosing the very good parts or the one he delights in, but he chooses everything, goes on systematically. Therefore, everything the Lord wants for us is presented before the church.
The
passage of today brings us to something very important, very essential, very central.
It is
just like the summary or the conclusion or the climax of what you have in the whole Bible.
It's
talking about the death of a substitute and the blood of the substitute. Adam and Eve sinned in the Garden of Eden. Do you remember? Immediately they sinned, God had to kill an animal and use the skin to cover their nakedness. An innocent one dying, shedding the blood for the guilty.
How was
Abel redeemed? Again, Abel took a lamb, took an animal, and killed it, the innocent, dying for the guilty. Remember what Noah did? He offered some of those pure, clean animals. He killed them, again, an atonement for the guilty.
You
remember that Isaac should have died? But then the Lord said, don't lay your hand on that child.
He looked up
and he saw a ram. And that ram died in the place of Isaac. Again, it is the innocent lamb, the innocent ram dying as a substitute in the place of another
one.
The children of Israel were in captivity in Egypt. And now they were to be delivered. Again, let every family take a lamb and kill it and shed the blood and apply the blood. When I see the blood, I will pass over
you.
It is the case of the innocent dying for the guilty, so that the guilty now can be free.
Nibe, atu ti ri pe alaise olo lati ku fun elese ki a ba le so as
they came to the wilderness, they were told how they will be making their sacrifices. And you find that if they were going to have favor with God, they will kill those animals, they will shed their blood, then they will go free. They went on like that until Isaiah made them to understand that somebody will come who will take the blame and the guilt of everyone.
He's
the one that identified Jesus Christ as the man of sorrows, who took our guilt, who took our condemnation. All our iniquities were laid upon him. Eventually, the moment Jesus came, John identified him and said, he pointed to him, "Behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world."
And
as you come through to the end of the New Testament, Revelation tells us in chapter 1 that he washed us from our sin in his own blood. Revelation says, "I saw the Lamb that was slain." He was slain for our iniquity.
If you want to say we mori odragutan na ti ati pa lati ipile aye yen pe apa nitori ese wa.
And so what commenced was began in the book of Genesis, an innocent dying for the guilty, continues till the book of Revelation as we talk about the blood of the Lamb. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb.
O wa fi pe ohun to bere lati nu iwe Genesis pe ki alaise ko ma ku nitori elese o lo tesiwaju titi de inu iwe ifihan ni bile ti Jesu Oluwa ti fi eje re to ti ta eje re sile iyen ni pe eje re yi o ni eri ti agbekele.
And it is this important central subject of redemption that we are considering today.
Koko eko to se pata.
You'll see two words that are very important as I have related to you all those events from Genesis to Revelation. One is the blood. Two, death. The death of the innocent substitute shedding his blood. Come now to Hebrews chapter
9.
If you look at Hebrews chapter 9, it's talking about the blood of the Lamb. In verse 12, it talks about blood of goats and calves. But then in that verse 12, by his own blood, he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. Look at verse 14, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal spirit offered himself without spot to God, to purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God.
He's
talking about the fact that we have been guilty, our conscience condemned us, but the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ is able to cleanse after we have been forgiven, and he purifies and purges our conscience. Verse 18, whereupon neither the first testament was dedicated without blood. Verse 19, for when Moses had spoken every precept to all the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and of goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop, and sprinkle both the book and all the people.
Ese ikokandelogun oni nitori nigbati Mose ti so gbogbo ase fun gbogbo awon eniyan gege bi ofin o mu ejo omo malu ati ti ewure pelu omi ati owu ododo ati ewe hyssop o si fi won ati iwe papa ati gbogbo eniyan.
You see, he's talking about the blood.
Ori ko so nipa eje na.
Verse 20 saying, this is the blood of the testament which God has enjoined unto you.
Ese ogun wi pe eyi ni eje majemu ti Olorun pa lase fun yin.
Verse 22. And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood is no remission.
O si fere je ohun gbogbo ni a fi eje wenu gege bi ofin ati lai si itaje sile ko si idarije.
So then you see he's talking about that important thing in the sight of God, the blood of the pure, perfect, holy, innocent substitute.
O wa le ri pe o so nipa ohun to se pataki ni oju Oluwa, eyi ni eje alaise eni mimo olododo ti o je pipe ni.
Number 2 is talking about death.
Ekeji o so nipa iku.
Because you see, guilty man, sinful man should have died.
Tori pe o je mo pe elebi elese eniyan iru eni be o ye ni ku.
But then if we're not going to die, somebody will be at that punishment for us.
Sugbon ti a ba wa ni ku wa yi enikan lati jiya ni.
And another person, as the Lord Jesus Christ, the perfect, the holy one, he has died for us. Look at verse 15. And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the first testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance.
Ati nitori eyi ni o se je alarina majemu ti to pe bi iku ti nbe fun idande awon ere koja ti o ti wa labe majemu isaaju ki awon ti a pe le ri ileri ogun aini pe kun gba.
You see, it says by means of death.
Oni nipa iku.
Verse 16. For where a testament is, there must of also of necessity be the death of the testator.
Nitori nibi ti iwe ogun ba gbe wa iku eni ti o se ko le se alaisi pelu.
So the passage is talking about the death of the innocent substitute, the Lord Jesus Christ our Savior, and it's talking about the shedding of his blood.
Nipa bayi ibi ti a tin keko yi o so nipa iku eni ti o je aropo wa to je mimo to je pipe o si to so nipa eje re.
In the passage we are looking at today, there are three things that the blood of Jesus Christ has done for us.
Ninu ibi ti a tin keko loni o meta.
Number 1 is redemption. Look at it in verse 15. And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by the means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were in the first that were under the first testament, that they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance. You see there, redemption.
Ni ese ikedogun ati nitori eyi ni o se je alarina majemu titun pe bi iku ti nbe fun idande awon ere koja ti o ti wa labe majemu saaju ki awon ti a pe le ri ileri ogun aini pe kun gba o ri pe o so nipa irapada ni yi.
Number 2 is the blood of Jesus Christ has granted us remission of sin.
Ekeji eje Jesu Kristi o ti ra idarije kuro ninu ese fun wa.
Look at verse 22.
Iwo wo ese ekeji lelogun.
And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood is no remission of sin.
O si fere je ohun gbogbo ni fi eje wenu gege bi ofin ati lai si itaje sile ko si idariji ese.
Number 1, redemption.
Akoko irapada.
Number 2, remission.
Ekeji idariji.
Number 3, there is righteousness through that blood.
Eketa ododo o nbe nipase eje na.
Look at verse 26.
Iwo wo ese ikerindinlogbon.
But then must he often have suffered since the foundation of the world, but now once in the end of the world as he appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself.
bi be ko o ki ba sai ma ji ya nigba ku gba lati ipile aye sugbon ni sisin yi ni o fi ara re han lekan soso ni opin aye lati mu ese kuro nipa ebo ara re
to put away sin
lati mu ese kuro
righteousness
ibi aye ododo ni
and those are the three things we're looking at today that get to us from the shedding of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ
awon kan meta ti a si gbe yawo loni ni iye ti a fi fun wa nipase eje ti Jesu Oluwata sile
number 1 redemption through his blood
akoko irapada nipa eje re
number 2 remission through his blood
ekeji dariji nipa eje re
number 3 righteousness through his blood
eketa ododo nipa eje re
let us now go and go into the verses themselves we'll start from verse 15
eje ki a wa lo sinu awon ese oro olorin fun re a bere lati ese ikedogun
we're looking at redemption
an wo ti irapada
we're talking about redemption because man was in bondage
an soro nipa irapada tori pe eniyan ti wa ni abe ijebo
sin brings us into bondage
ese o ma mu ni lo sinu igbeku
the bondage of sin itself
igbekun ti ese fun ara
e the bondage of satan
igbekun ti satani
sin gives satan the privilege or the opportunity to fashion a stronghold around us and to keep us in captivity and we're so helpless we could not deliver ourselves
ese o lo ran satani lowo lati le mo odi biriko to yi wa ka to be gele ta fi wa nu ahama ati igbeku esu ti a o fi le rara wa
lowo the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ
sugbe nigba ti Jesu Oluwade
is dying for us
iku re fun wa
is standing in our place
o duro ni gege bi arapo wa
in bearing our guilt condemnation and shame
o ru ese ebi ati itiju wa
he broke the yoke
o fu ajaga na
he delivered us
o wa da wa ni de
he took us away from the slave market of the devil
o wa ra wa kuro ni oko eru esu
He took us away from exile, from captivity. He broke the fetters, he broke the chains. He removed the weaknesses and the feebleness of our personality, of our lives. He brought us from darkness, from imprisonment. He brought us to the free land. He sets us free and we now become the children of God, the Son and the daughters of God. Because he shed his blood, we are redeemed. We are taken from the captivity of sin and we are taken from the captivity of Satan. Look at verse 15. For this cause is the mediator of the New Testament. This word mediator in the original. It means a bridge. You see, man had been separated from God. And there was a great gulf, a great chasm, a great pit, a great ditch between God and man. And no man was able to jump that ditch or that gulf and then pass onto God's side. It was so wide, it was so deep. All our religion could not bridge that gap. Our good works could not bridge that gap. Our gentleness, our kindness, our social work, our philanthropic work could not bridge that gap.
We were
condemned, we were damned with no hope of salvation. All the attempt of man to come near God, immediately they came to that edge of the pit, they couldn't jump, they couldn't move on, and there was no bridge to connect us with the Almighty God.
Gbogbo ilakaka eniyan lati fe sin Olorun ati lati fe wa oju Olorun ni gege to ba ti de eti bebe koto ti o pala laarin eniyan ati Olorun iko ni le fo ibe koja lati sumo Olorun.
How could then we cross to the other side and meet God? How could we be reconciled unto God? How could we come into the immediate presence of God? How could we come into fellowship with God? We needed a bridge to be able to cross over. And the mediator, the word mediator means bridge. And Jesus Christ has become the bridge. He has become the way unto the Father. He has become the one through whom we walk and come to the presence of the Father. You see the bridges that are made? You see there is no discrimination? The bridge is there for everyone. If you want to cross from this side to the other side, the man can come, the woman can come, the white can come, the black can come, the weak can come, the strong can come. Because this mediator is for everyone. It's a bridge that leads us to God. No matter what sins you have committed, you can come on this bridge on the mediator on Jesus Christ and walk straight to the presence of God. And it is that makes him to become our Redeemer. For this cause, he is a mediator, he is a bridge of the new covenant of the New Testament. That by means of death for the redemption of transgressions. For the redemption of the transgressions. It says the transgressions that were under the first testament. What does that mean? You see, as you read the Old Testament, you will see that there were transgressions that carry death penalty. From Genesis chapter 2, you will not eat of the fruit of that tree. The day you eat it, you will die.
Genesis
chapter
3,
because you have done this, dust now art, and to dust will you return dead.
Genesis
chapter 4, Cain, why have you done this? The blood of your brother is calling unto me. And again, curse came upon him until you will leave the face of the earth dead.
Genesis
Abimelech, the woman which is another man's wife, if you don't return this woman, you will surely die.
Abimelech,
as you come to Exodus, you see that if you do this, you get a stick on Sabbath day, you do this, you do that, dead.
What
you read in Leviticus says about the penalty of death. The soul that does this, the soul that does that, he has sinned, he has trespassed against the Lord, he has become unclean, he shall die the death, a sin shall be upon him. Deuteronomy is a reminder of all that they had said from Exodus to Numbers, and it is still saying the soul that has done this, that went to the dead, sought familiar spirit, or that did it to defile himself, he has committed abomination in the sight of the Lord, he shall die for his iniquity. As you move on to the Old Testament, you see that in that first covenant, in that first testament, the climax of it is the soul that sinneth, it shall die. And so it says, all those transgressions that carry death penalty, we who are living now, we have transgressed against the law. But he says, although we should have died, our Redeemer, by means of death, he has redeemed us from the transgressions which were under the first covenant, under the first testament.
ẹni tí ó rà wá padà nípasẹ̀ ikú ó ti wá rà wá padà kúrò nínú ìdájọ́ ti ikú ètò wà nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú láíláí.
He died in our place.
Ó kú gẹ́gẹ́ bí arọ́pò
wa. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Ikú ó ní èrè ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ ṣùgbọ́n ẹ̀bùn ọ̀fẹ́ Olúwa ó ní iye tí kò ní pẹ̀kú nípasẹ̀ Jésù Kristo Olúwa.
Now he says in that verse 15 that they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance.
Ó wá sọ ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹẹ̀dógún yìí pé kí àwọn tí a ti pè lè rí ìlérí ogún àìní pẹ̀kún gbà.
He now tells us, after you trust in the Lord Jesus Christ and you believe he has died in your place, you are not going to die anymore. You are passed from condemnation unto life. In fact, now you have eternal life, you have eternal inheritance.
Ó wá sọ fún wa wípé ní gẹ́rẹ́ tí a bá ti gbàgbọ́ nínú Jésù Kristo Olúwa tí a sì gbẹ́kẹ̀lé ètùtù tí ó ṣe fún wa ní orí igi àgbélébó nípa báyìí a wá rí ikú kọjá bọ́ sínú ìyè a ò ní kú mọ́.
Oh, you say, why is this death necessary?
Ó wá sọ pé kí ló dé tí ikú yìí fi ṣe
pàtàkì. Then he brings a practical illustration.
Ó wá mú àpèjúwe tí a lè fi sójú
ṣe. Have you seen the people that write a will before they die?
Ó wá ń bèrè pé ǹjọ́ wa ti rí àwọn ènìyàn tí wọ́n kọ ìwé ogún kó tó di pé wọ́n kú.
When they write that will,
ìgbà wo bá kọ ìwé ogún
wọn? That will is a testament.
Ìwé ogún yìí ó jẹ́ mọ́jẹ̀mú.
And you will not have the benefits in that will, in that testament, until the person, the testator, the fellow was reaching that will, until he has died.
Ó wá sọ pé o lè jàǹfààní ìwé ogún yìí tí ṣe mọ́jẹ̀mú yìí níwọ̀n ìgbà tí ẹni tó kọ ìwé ogún yẹn bá wà láyè àfìgbà tí ẹni yẹn bá kú ló tó lè jàǹfààní.
He is proving the necessity of the death of Jesus Christ before the benefit of eternal life can become ours.
Ó fi ìdí ìṣe pàtàkì ikú Jésù Olúwa múlẹ̀ kó tó di pé àǹfààní ìyà ìnípẹ̀kún yóò lè jẹ́ tiwa.
In verse 16, for where a testament is, there must also of necessity be the death of the testator.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹrìndínlógún, ó ní nítorí níbi tí ìwé ogún bá gbé wà, ikú ẹni tí ó ṣe é kò lè ṣe aláìsí pẹ̀lú.
Why?
Kí ló fà?
Verse 17.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹtàdínlógún.
For because a testament is of force after men are dead, otherwise it is of no strength at all, while the testator liveth.
Ó ní nítorí ìwé ogún ní agbára lẹ́yìn ìgbà tí ènìyàn bá kú. Nítorí kò ní agbára rárá nígbà tí ẹni tí ó ṣe ń bá ń bẹ láàyè.
That means the Lord has made a will for us.
Ìyẹn ni pé Olúwa ti fi ìwé ogún kan fún wa.
Through him we have eternal life.
Nípasẹ̀ rẹ̀ la fi ní ìyà
ìnípẹ̀kún. Through him we are reconciled unto God.
Nípasẹ̀ rẹ̀ la fi bá Ọlọ́run làjà.
He is the door, he is the way.
Ó ní ẹnu ọ̀nà náà, ó ní ojú ọ̀nà náà.
By him we can come to the presence of God.
Nípasẹ̀ rẹ̀ ó la fi lè wá síwájú
Bàbá. By him we lose all the weight, all the load, all the condemnation, all the guilt of our sin.
Nípasẹ̀ rẹ̀ la fi jàjàbọ́ kúrò nínú gbogbo ẹrù ruwa ti ajaga ti esu ti so mo wa lorun tele.
By him we have eternal life.
Nipase re la ni iya
ni pekun. Through him we have eternal inheritance.
Nipase re la ni ogun ai ni
pekun. Through him the gate of heaven is open for us.
Nipase re ni asilekun orun sile ni
waju wa baya. Through him the gate of hell is closed and we are not going to go to hell.
Nipase re la fi tilekun orun apadi gbengbe ti a o fini
lo sun apadi. Through him the riches of glory, the riches of the kingdom of God are available for us.
Nipase re o ni oro nu ogo oro ti ijoba olorun lo wa ni arowo to fun wa.
It is written in his will. He has provided everything for us. Well, but if he has written a will, it will be necessary that the testator will die before the provisions of the will will become ours.
Ṣùgbọ́n ṣá, káti ẹ̀ pé ó kọ ìwé ogún yìí sílẹ̀ fún wa, ó ṣe pàtàkì fún ẹ tí ó kọ ìwé ogún yìí láti kú kí àǹfààní ìwé ogún yìí kó ba lè jẹ́ tiwa.
And so he has died for us.
Nípa báyìí ó ti wá kú fún wa.
And the benefits of the will, the benefits of the New Testament, they now become ours.
Àwọn àǹfààní ìwé ogún ti mọ́jẹ̀mú titun yìí ó wá di ìpín wa báyìí.
Remember that word mediator again?
Ìrántí gbólóhùn alárinà lẹ́ẹ̀kan
sí. That it means the bridge.
Ipe ó túmọ̀ sí o pé afárá ni.
That means everyone can go on that bridge.
Èyí sì wá túmọ̀ sí pé gbogbo èèyàn ló lè gba orí afárá náà.
There is no discrimination.
Kò sí pé bóyá à ń dá ẹnìkan yàtọ̀.
And you walk on the bridge every day, maybe every day.
Bóyá o tilẹ̀ máa ń rìn lórí afárá lójoojúmọ́.
And nobody says you have no right.
Kò sẹ́ni tó halẹ̀ mọ́ pé o lẹ́tọ̀
láti. Because you are not from the right tribe.
Torí pé ò wá láti ẹ̀yà tó tọ́ sí.
There is no tribalism. Everyone goes on that bridge.
Kò sí ẹlẹ́yàmẹ̀yà nínú ọ̀rọ̀ náà, gbogbo èèyàn ló lè gba orí afárá
náà. Jesus is now the bridge.
Jésù wà ní afárá náà.
Between man and God.
Láàrin ènìyàn àti Ọlọ́run.
And every one of us without discrimination.
Gbogbo wa láìsí pé bóyá ẹlẹ́yàmẹ̀yà.
You now have the privilege of going on that bridge. He is your mediator. Now you can go to God.
O ní àǹfààní láti gba orí afárá náà wá síwájú Ọlọ́run torí pé ò ní alárinà rẹ̀.
In 1 Timothy chapter 2.
Nínú Timothy 2.
reading from verse 3. For this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who will have all men to be saved. He wants you to be saved. If you are backsliding, that's accidental. It is not the will of God that you remain in backsliding. Who will have all men to be saved and to come unto the knowledge of the truth. You can come on that bridge because Jesus is the mediator. In verse 5, for there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus. Who gave himself a ransom for all, to be testified in due time. He tells us he has made himself a ransom, his redeemer, and is available for everyone. If Ephesians chapter 1 verse 7. Again, he's telling us redemption through the blood of the Lamb, in whom we have redemption through his blood, forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace. Remember, redemption is not on your own merit, it's on the merit of the Lord Jesus Christ, the blood of Jesus. If it's by merit, some will get, some will not be able to get. Not by merit, it's through the blood of Jesus Christ we are redeemed. In 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 18, for as much as you know that you were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold from your vain conversation received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ as of a lamb without blemish and without spot.
Níwọ̀n bí ẹ̀yin ti mọ̀ pé a kò fi ohun tí dìbàjẹ́ rà yín padà bíi fàdákà tàbí wúrà kúrò nínú ìwà asán yín tí ẹ̀yin ti jogún láti ọ̀dọ̀ àwọn bàbá yín, bí kò ṣe ẹ̀jẹ̀ iyebíye bíi ti ọ̀dọ̀ àgùntàn tí kò ní àbùkù tí kò sì ní àbàwọ́n àní ẹ̀jẹ̀ Kristi.
So then he tells us redemption is available for everyone through the blood of Jesus Christ.
Ó wá fi hàn fún wa wípé ìràpadà ń bẹ fún gbogbo ènìyàn nípasẹ̀ ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù Kristi
Olúwa. When we talk of salvation,
nígbà bá ń sọ̀rọ̀ nípa ìgbàlà,
as a student of the Bible, you need to know that salvation has many parts.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí akẹ́kọ̀ọ́ Bíbélì, ó yẹ kó mọ̀ pé ìgbàlà ó ní àwọn ẹ̀ka.
When we talk of salvation, there is forgiveness of sin in salvation. When we talk of salvation, there is redemption from the curse and from the hand of the devil, from bondage in salvation. When we talk of salvation, we're also talking of the renewal of our lives. We become new creatures, regeneration inside that salvation. When we talk of salvation, we are talking of adoption into the family of God. That's our sonship. We are now the children of God. When we talk of salvation, we talk about reconciliation. There is no enmity between us and God now. Inside that salvation we are talking about, there is reconciliation. When we talk of salvation, we are talking also about righteousness. He now makes us righteous. In fact, we become the righteousness of God in him.
We're
talking about life. We were dead before. Now we come to life. There is life in salvation. Eternal life.
So,
as this passage is talking about our salvation, he mentions the aspect of redemption through his blood. He looks at salvation now, and he looks at another aspect, and he's not going to talk about remission of sin. That brings us to point number two in our study today. Redemption through his blood. Again, please remember, it is always through his blood. You see, there are people who come over here and they say they repent and repent and pray and pray, and they tell us that for many, many months, for many, many years, they have been coming, they have not been saved. They're depending on their feeling. They're saying that, well, the way I feel, I don't believe that my sins have been forgiven. Redemption is not through our feeling. Redemption is through his blood. Redemption, remission of sin, the taking away of our sin, is not through the way we feel, it is through the shedding of his blood. Once you place your faith in Christ, leave your feeling aside. It is faith, not feeling. As you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, what his blood has made available for everyone will become your own.
Then
look at it now. Remission through his blood. Reading from verse 18. Whereupon, neither the first testament was dedicated without blood. For when Moses had spoken every precept unto all the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and of goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop and sprinkled both upon the book and all the people.
Nítorí nígbà tí Mose ti sọ gbogbo àṣẹ fún gbogbo àwọn ènìyàn gẹ́gẹ́ bí òfin, ó mú ẹ̀jẹ̀ ọmọ màálù àti ewúrẹ́ pẹ̀lú omi àti òwú òdòdó àti ewé isopu, ó sì fi wọ́n àti ìwé pàápàá àti gbogbo ènìyàn.
Saying, this is the blood of the testament which God has enjoined unto you.
Wípé èyí ni ẹ̀jẹ̀ májẹ̀mú tí Ọlọ́run pa láṣẹ fún yín.
And in Exodus, you'll see what we're talking about. Exodus chapter 24.
Nínú Exodus wa rí ohun tí a sọ nípa ẹ̀ ní Exodus orí 24.
Correct it on your outline. It's verses 6 to 8, not 68. Verses 6 to 8.
Ṣé àtúnṣe rẹ̀ bí a ti kọ́ ní èdè Yorùbá ó dára bẹ́ẹ̀.
In Exodus chapter 24, we're looking at it from verse 6.
Exodus orí 24 láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹfà láti ń wò.
And Moses took half of the blood and put it in basins, and half of the blood he sprinkled on the altar.
Moses sì mú àbọ̀ ẹ̀jẹ̀ náà, ó sì fi wọ́n sínú àwokòtò àti àbọ̀ ẹ̀jẹ̀ náà, ó sì fi wọ́n ara pẹpẹ náà.
And he took the book of the covenant and read in the ears of the people, and they said, all that the Lord has said we will do and be obedient.
Ó sì mú ìwé májẹ̀mú ni, ó sì kà ní etí àwọn ènìyàn, wọ́n sì wí pé gbogbo èyí tí Olúwa wí ni àwa ó ṣe, àwa ó sì gbọ́ràn.
And Moses took the blood and sprinkled it on the people and said, behold the blood of the covenant which the Lord has made with you concerning all these words.
Moses sì mú ẹ̀jẹ̀ náà, ó sì wọ́n sára àwọn ènìyàn, ó sì wí pé kíyèsí, ẹ̀jẹ̀ májẹ̀mú tí Olúwa bá yín dá nípasẹ̀ ọ̀rọ̀ gbogbo wọ̀nyí.
And therefore you can see here that that first covenant, it was ratified, it was established, it was confirmed through the blood that was sprinkled upon the people and upon the book of the covenant.
O wa le ri ninu bi ti aka yi pe majemu ti isaju la fi idi re mole, eti a fi ese re mo And
so you see, it depends upon the blood of the Lamb.
And
for the removal of your sin, for the forgiveness of all your sins, the removal, the cleansing of everything that you ever did wrong in your life.
It
is based on the shedding of the blood of Jesus Christ. Without the blood, the shedding of the blood, there will be no remission. Please come back to Hebrews chapter 9, verses 21 and 22. Moreover, he sprinkled the blood both with the blood, both the tabernacle and all the vessels of the ministry. Now you will see something very important here. You see all those Old Testament rituals and ceremonies and all the things they did. Even the tabernacle itself and the vessels of ministry, that is, the vessels for their services, none of them will be accepted in the sight of God until it was sprinkled by the blood. Because you need to understand now, the world, the earth had been cursed. Man had been cursed. Therefore, man and his so-called talent, man and his so-called ability, man and his so-called wisdom, since man is under the curse, his ability, his talent, his gift, everything was under the curse. Therefore needed redemption before any of those things, whether gift or ability or usefulness or whatever, will be acceptable in the sight of God. The earth also had been cursed. And every vessel, every instrument, you know, if you are going to make a pot, you get the clay out of the ground. If you are going to make an iron vessel or whatever, they take the iron from the ground. All these instruments, everything, the earth had been cursed.
So
the Lord was telling them that all those instruments you make, all those vessels of ministry, before they can even be acceptable in my sight, they will be sprinkled with blood. Then I will know that they have been redeemed and they are brought unto me. And you too, you have been redeemed, you are brought unto me. That's why it says everything has to be sprinkled with blood.
That's
why they had to sprinkle the blood on the tabernacle and all the vessels of ministry to remove the effect of the curse from them, and now they can use them to offer service unto the Lord.
Verse 22,
almost all things are by the law purged with blood. Looking at all their services, the man, the vessel, the instrument, whatever it is, everything, before they could use them in service, all things, almost all things, had to be sprinkled with the blood to make them acceptable in the sight of the
Lord.
He now tells us the conclusion in that verse 22, without shedding of blood is no remission. 23, it was therefore necessary that the patterns of things in the heavens should be purified with these, but the heavenly things themselves with better sacrifices than these.
It
tells us our souls could not have been forgiven, all our sins could not have been taken away, we couldn't have had remission of sin without the shedding of the blood, because it is the blood that makes atonement for the soul.
O so pe okan wa ki ba ti ni anfani ati gba idariji ati iwenumo ko ba ti si anfani fun wa tori pe lai si itaje sile a o le gba idariji.
It's not the labor of our hand that gives us remission of sin.
Ki se lala tabi ise owo wa ni o fun ani idariji ese wa.
Not our ability, not our arms giving.
Ki se ipa wa tabi ore itore anu wa.
Nothing we have done.
Ko si ore re kan ta le se.
Because everything had been under the curse.
Tori pe gbogbo nkan ninu aye lo wa labe ego.
But it is as we are cleansed by the blood of the lamb.
Sugba bi awa tin we wa mo nipa se
ejodo. It is the blood of the lamb that makes atonement for your soul. In Leviticus chapter 17 verse 11. Leviticus 17:11. For the life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it to you upon the altar to make an atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul.
Nitori pe emi ara nbe ninu eje emi si ti fi fun yin lati ma fi se etutu fun okan yin lori pepe ni nitori pe eje ni se etutu fun okan.
And so is the blood of the lamb, the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, that has given us remission of sin.
Nipa bayi nipa se eje odo agutan na eje Jesu Kristi Oluwa on lati le ri idariji ese.
That's how we got saved.
Ba tin de ni igbala ni.
That's how we became children of God.
Ba se n di omo Olorun ni.
The question now is,
ibere to wa wa nbe ni pe,
after we have become born again,
leyin gba ta di
after we have become children of God, we're no more living in sin like the worldly people, the people who are living in sin. Do we need that blood of Jesus anymore? Or is it that, well, I've been saved, it's done it, and that's forever settled? I'm already saved. I'm already sanctified. I'm already baptized in the Holy Ghost. Is there any necessity anymore for me to have faith in the blood of the Lamb? Let's look at 1 John chapter 1. Verse 7. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another.
Ṣùgbọ́n bí àwa bá ń rìn nínú ìmọ́lẹ̀, bí òun ti ń bẹ nínú ìmọ́lẹ̀, àwa ní ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú ara wa.
Already we have been born again.
A ti di àtòbínà.
We are walking in the light.
À ń rìn nínú ìmọ́lẹ̀.
As he is in the light.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí òun ṣe wà ní ìmọ́lẹ̀.
And we have fellowship with one another.
A sì ní ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú ara wa.
Then it says, and the blood of Jesus Christ his son cleanseth us from all sin.
O wa tẹ̀síwájú, ó ní ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù Kristi ọmọ rẹ̀ ní wẹ̀ wá nù kúrò nínú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ gbogbo.
But already we are saved.
A ti dẹni ìgbàlà náà.
But already we are made holy.
A sá ti sọ wá di mímọ́.
Already we are in fellowship with God, we are in fellowship with one another.
Lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́ bá a ti ní ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú Ọlọ́run àti ara wa.
In fact, we even have the Holy Ghost in our lives.
A tilẹ̀ ní ẹ̀mí mímọ́ nínú ayé
wa. We have power and privilege for service.
A ní agbára àti àǹfààní fún iṣẹ́ ìsìn.
And we are walking in the light.
A sì ń rìn nínú ìmọ́lẹ̀.
In the light that we know.
Inú ìmọ́lẹ̀ tá a mọ̀.
And then he still say, even as you are walking in the light, it is still the blood of his son Jesus Christ that cleanses, that's in the present tense, continual present tense, that keeps cleansing us from all sin.
Ó wá sọ pé bó tilẹ̀ jẹ́ pé a ti rìn nínú ìmọ́lẹ̀ tí a sì ní ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú ara wa yìí, síbẹ̀ ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù Kristi ọmọ rẹ̀ òun ló ń wẹ̀ wá nù, ìyẹn ni pé ní gbogbo ìgbà ló sì ń wẹ̀ wá nù kúrò nínú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ gbogbo wa.
Do you realize that as a child of God,
ó wá mọ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọmọ Ọlọ́run,
there are things you are supposed to do, either because of forgetfulness you didn't do it, and if God were to look at a standard in a very rigid manner, that will still be a sin in the sight of God.
O mọ̀ pé gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọmọ Ọlọ́run, àwọn nǹkan míì wà tó yẹ kó o ṣe, bóyá nítorí pé ọkàn rẹ tètè máa ń gbàgbé, o ṣe nǹkan náà, tí Ọlọ́run bá sì fẹ́ bójú wo nǹkan yẹn kí ó tẹjú mọ gan, ohun yìí yóò máa dàbí ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ níwájú rẹ̀.
He that knows to do good, all right, and does not do it, to him it is sin.
Ẹnikẹ́ni tó bá mọ bí àti ṣe rere tí kò ṣe, ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ ni fúnra
ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀. There are some things you may not deliberately do going into sin.
Àwọn nǹkan kan wà tí kìí ṣe pé bóyá o mọ̀ mọ̀ ṣe
nípa lọ sí ẹ̀ṣẹ̀. But if God, who is of purer eyes than to behold iniquity, if he were to look at your life and look at your attitude and look at everything you are doing, he will see that this is not perfect, completely white in his sight.
Ọlọ́run ẹni tí ojú rẹ̀ mọ̀ ju àti wo ibi lọ, nígbà tí o bá tẹjú mọ́ gbogbo àwọn nǹkan tó ń ṣe, tó wo gbogbo ìwàsí rẹ̀, ó lè ṣàkíyèsí pé nǹkan kan wà tó jẹ́ pé kò pé bó ṣe yẹ kó pé níwájú
Olúwa. He would say, I have not found thy work perfect in my sight.
Ó lè wí pé n kò tí ì rí kí iṣẹ́ rẹ kó pé níwájú mi.
Say, Lord, but I'm walking in the light.
Ó wá sọ pé Olúwa, ṣùgbọ́n mò ń rìn nínú ìmọ̀lẹ̀.
All the light I know I'm walking in it.
Gbogbo ìmọ̀lẹ̀ tí mo lóye nípa rẹ̀ ni mò ń rìn
nínú rẹ̀. He says, yes, but when I look at you, there are things you should have been doing you are not doing.
Ó ní bẹ́ẹ̀ ni, ṣùgbọ́n gbà mo wọ̀ ọ́ láwò dunjú, mo rí pé àwọn nǹkan kan wà tó yẹ kó máa ṣe tó ṣe.
He said, Lord, what is the way out?
Ó wá sọ pé Olúwa, kí ni ọ̀nà àbájáde?
The blood.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ náà.
Go back to the blood.
Padà sínú ẹ̀jẹ̀
yìí. The blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù Kristì ọmọ rẹ̀ ní wẹ̀wá nù kúrò nínú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ gbogbo.
How many times you should have preached to somebody?
Mélòó ìgbà ló yẹ kó ti wàásù fún ẹnìkan?
And one day you woke up, you say, let me now go and preach to him.
Ó wá jí níjọ́ kan, wá ní jẹ́ kí n lọ wàásù fún ẹni náà.
And then you realize the fellow is gone, is nowhere to be found.
Ó wá gbọ́ pé ẹni yẹn ti lọ, ó sì mọ ibi tó ti lè rí.
What are you going to do now?
Kí ló wà ṣe báyìí?
The blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù Kristì ọmọ rẹ̀ ní wẹ̀wá nù kúrò nínú
ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ gbogbo. So you will see then that you need the efficacy of the cleansing of the blood of Jesus every time.
Ó wá rí pé o nílò ìwẹ̀nùmọ́ àti ìwẹ̀mọ́ nínú ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù Kristì ńgbà gbogbo.
Because you see, without it, you will not be continually, permanently acceptable in the sight of the Lord.
Torí pé láìsí ẹ̀jẹ̀ rẹ̀ yìí, o ní yẹlẹ́ni ìtẹ́wọ́gbà nígbà gbogbo níwájú Olúwa.
See Revelation chapter 1.
Ìwọ́wọ́ ìfihàn orí kìíní.
And read verses 5 and 6.
Mo ń ka ẹsẹ̀ ìkarùn-ún àti ìkẹfà.
It says, from Jesus Christ, who is a faithful witness, and the first begotten of the dead, and the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood.
Ó ní àti láti ọ̀dọ̀ Jésù Kristì, ẹlẹ́rìí olóòótọ́, àkọ́bí nínú àwọn òkú àti aláṣẹ àwọn ọba ayé, ẹni tí ó fẹ́ wa, tí ó sì wẹ̀ wá nínú ẹ̀jẹ̀ rẹ̀ kúrò nínú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ wa.
He washed us in his own blood.
Tí ó wẹ̀ wá nínú ẹ̀jẹ̀ rẹ̀.
Your own morality cannot wash you clean enough to be acceptable in the sight of God.
Ìwà ọmọlúàbí rẹ kò lè wẹ̀ ọ́ mọ́ kó o fi lè yẹlẹ́ni ìtẹ́wọ́gbà níwájú
Ọlọ́run. Your services of religion will not wash you clean enough and be acceptable in the sight of God.
Iṣẹ́ ìsìn rẹ nínú ẹ̀sìn tó ń sìn, ìyẹn ò lè wẹ̀ ọ́ mọ́ kó o mọ́ nínú lóde níwájú Ọlọ́run.
I am innocent, I am holy, that's not enough.
Aláìṣẹ̀ ni mí, èèyàn mi mọ́ ni mí mi
yóò tó. It is the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ that washes us, that cleanses us, and makes us presentable in the sight of the Almighty Father.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù Kristì Olúwa, òun ló ń wẹ̀ wá mọ́, òun ló sì mú wa yẹlẹ́ni ìtẹ́wọ́gbà níwájú Bàbá.
Revelation chapter 5, reading from verse 9.
Ìfihàn orí karùn-ún a ó kà láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹsàn-án.
And he sang a new song saying, thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seals thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by thy blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation.
Wọ́n sì ń kọ orin tuntun kan wípé ìwọ ni ó yẹ láti gba ìwé náà àti láti sí èdìdí rẹ̀, nítorí tí a ti pa ọ́, ìwọ sì ti fi ẹ̀jẹ̀ rẹ ṣe ìràpadà ènìyàn sí Ọlọ́run láti inú ẹ̀yà gbogbo àti èdè gbogbo àti inú ènìyàn gbogbo àti orílẹ̀-èdè gbogbo wa.
Can you see the privilege we have of being called the children of God is by the washing, the cleansing of the blood of Jesus Christ.
Ó wá lè rí pé àǹfààní tá a ní tí a fi ń pè wá ní ọmọ Ọlọ́run òun ni nípasẹ̀ ìwẹ̀nùmọ́ ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù
Kristì. When eventually you get to heaven,
nígbà tó o bá tilẹ̀ dọ́run,
are you joining the redeemed saints in glory?
Tó o darapọ̀ mọ́ àwọn ẹni ìràpadà mi mọ́
Ọlọ́run? And you look back on all the activities, everything that happened on earth.
Tó o sì wá fojú inú wo gbogbo àwọn ìṣẹ̀lẹ̀ tó ti ṣẹlẹ̀ nínú ayé
yìí. The only song you'll be able to sing.
Orin kan ṣoṣo náà ti wà láǹfààní àti kan.
Will be the song of glory to the Lamb.
Yóò jẹ́ orin fífi ògo fún ọ̀dọ́
àgùntàn náà. You will not say, praise the Lord, I am here in heaven because I was clever, because I did this, because I was this, because I was that. You'll say, give glory to God, I'm now in heaven because of the washing, the cleansing in the blood of the Lamb.
Ò ní máa kọrin gbò bá dọ̀rùn pé ògo ni fún Ọlọ́run, torí pé mo dé ìlú ọ̀run rere nípa nipa pe mo je en to ja fafa to si gban fefe ati nipa ise ododo ara mi mo fi debe oni ma ko rorin be bi ko se pe o ma fi ogo fun odragutan na en ti o fi eje
ra pada. Not your merit, not my marriage is blood.
Ki se nipa mi ma se emi tabi ti re bi ko se nipa eje
na. The race is not for the sweet, it's not for the clever, it is for the people that believe in the blood of the lamb.
Ire si sana ki se fun awon ti won je akikanju tabi awon alagbara bi ko se fun awon ti won gbekele ninu eje iwenu ma
Jesu. Victory is not for the strong. It is for the people that believe in the blood of the Lamb. And so number one, we have redemption through His blood. Number two, we have remission through His blood. Number three, praise the Lord, we have righteousness through His blood. We come to Hebrews chapter 9. Verse 24 all through to verse 28. Correct it on your outline. Now it says from verse 24, for Christ is not entered into the holy places made with hands, which are the figures of the true, but into the heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God for us.
Oni nitori Kristi ko wo ibi mimo ti a fi owo se lo lati se lo ti se apere ti otito sugbon o lo si orun papa ni sisin lati farahan ni waju Olorun fun wa.
Now he's talking about the Lord Jesus Christ.
Ni o so nipa Jesu
Oluwa. He has entered into the holy place, the holy place in heaven, not the holy place on earth.
O ti wo ibi mimo julo Olorun ki se ibi mimo julo tinu aye
yi. He has entered into heaven itself.
O ti wo nu Orun fun ara e lo.
Then it says to appear in the presence of God. If you stop there, to appear in the presence of God.
What
yourself does that concern me? Because Jesus Christ, the Son of God, He came into this world. He did everything the Father wanted Him to do. And now He's come back to the presence of God. But you see those two words there at the end of verse 24. It changes everything. It says it is for us. The gate to heaven is open. The presence of God is available for you. Forgiveness of sin has been made available. And the Lord is before the Father in heaven making intercession for you. He did it on the cross. Now he has a continual ongoing ministry before the Father for you. When you are weak, is strong, is there for you. When it appears the battle is raging against your life, the Lord Jesus Christ is in the presence of God for you. When it appears that you are so weak and the devil may overcome you, the Lord Jesus Christ is in the presence of God for you.
He
says, but he has entered into heaven itself now to appear in the presence of God for us.
Not
yet that he should offer himself often as a high priest, as the high priest entereth into the holy place every year with the blood of others. He's telling us now in the New Covenant, he doesn't need to be dying on the cross every year, every Easter.
There
are some religious people that feel that there must be somebody nailed on the cross as they commemorate Easter or whatever it is every time. He has done it once and for all. It says in verse 26, for then must he have often suffered since the foundation of the world. But now, once in the end of the world, as he appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself, and as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this, the judgment. He said, normally, there is judgment judgment because of sin. It's appointed unto men once to die. Immediately after that death, there should be judgment following. Then, do we then tremble and say, well, when I die, I'm going to face judgment?
No,
Christ is representing you. He has appeared in the presence of God for us. Verse 28. Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many. To carry the sins of many. To remove the sins of many. Who are the many? As many as received him. Who are the many? As many as respond to the call of God. Many are called. Who are the many? As many as believed in his name. Who are the many? As many as will come today and say, yes, I put my faith and trust in Christ. So Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many. And unto them that look for him. He came once, is coming the second time. The first time he came, it was to suffer. The second time he comes is to reign. The first time he came, it was to make sacrifice. The second time he comes, he's going to judge the world. The first time he came as Savior. The next time he comes, he's going to come as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The first time he came, it was to make sacrifice so that people can be saved. The second time he comes, he's going to gather all his saints from all over the world and we shall reign with him. The first time he came, he was crucified. The second time he comes, he's going to come in the clouds and he's going to appear in majesty and in power and in glory, and all eyes shall see him. And those who are looking for him, those who are preparing, those who are like the wise virgins, those who are saying we are waiting for our Lord, those who believe that the time is coming when the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, and we who are alive will be caught up together with them in the clouds. That is, those who believe in the promise he has given, that in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you that I go to prepare a place for you. That when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. That I will take you unto myself. Unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin. Without sin. Number one, without sin offering. He's not coming to make offering for sin anymore. That he has done. And he has said, it is finished. So, the people that are looking for him, they are the people that believe that sacrifice once made, for all made, and now they believe on the Lord, and they're looking for the coming of the Lord. And then it says, without sin. That is, the people that are looking for him, they have believed on the sacrifice that he made, and now they are living by the grace of God without sin, without blame, without blemish, without sin.
And
then it says, unto salvation. Yes, we are saved now, and will be saved at that time. There is initial salvation now. There is salvation from sin. There is a forgiveness of sin. There is a cleansing from sin. There is a purifying of the heart. There is adoption into the family of God. There is a removal of the curse from us. There is a righteousness of God in us. There is salvation now. There is salvation at that time too. When there will be no temptation anymore, there will be no trial anymore, even Satan will not have any authority over you anymore. The tears he will wipe away, all the burden he will take away, and the sun shall not have his seat over you, and all the toil and all the labor, everything will be over. That is final salvation. And the devil, no devil anymore will trouble you, no demon anymore will trouble you, no problem anymore will trouble your life, no affliction anymore will trouble your life. And then you will say, I was saved, saved from sin. Now I am saved, never to return to the world anymore. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. That final salvation, when he will wipe all the tears away. That final salvation, when there will be no sorrow, there will be no death, there will be no agony, there will be no problem, there will be no trial, there will be no tribulation, there will be no trouble, and there will be no demons harassing your life. There will be no bad dream, there will be no sickness, there will be no harassment of the devil. When we all go up yonder, when we walk the streets of gold, when we will be with the Lord, when we will smile and never stop laughing, when there will be joy unspeakable, when there will be peace that passes understanding, when we will walk up and down in heaven, when we will be in the midst of the angels of God, when we will rejoice forevermore, when we will say, I am free, I am free, there is no persecution anymore, there is no problem anymore, there is no tear anymore, there is no labor anymore, there is no problem, and we are just in heaven, ever, 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 forever to be with the Lord. Final salvation. And the devil cannot touch you, and the devil cannot tempt you, and sickness cannot come upon you, and infirmity cannot come upon you, and you will be like the angels of God. You will be shining with the glory of God forever and ever. You will be in the mansion. You will be wearing the white robe. You will have a crown on your head. He will give you a reward. You will be victorious forever. You will be triumphant. You will be singing the song of the Lamb. You will be among the redeemed of the Lord. The final, final, final salvation. When nobody will terrify your life, because you'll be within the you'll be in heaven, and the gates of the place, the gate will not be locked in the day and in the night, and the lamp will be the light thereof, and you will be the children of God. And he will say, I have made all things perfect. He will give you reward. He will put a crown on your head. He will give you the morning star. He will give you the manna. He will show you, you are mine, I am yours. You will walk in the paradise of God. You will be looking at the face of Jesus Christ. You will be fellowshipping with the Almighty God. You will be in the company of Moses, of Aaron, of Abraham, of Joshua, of Elijah, of Elisha. You will be in the fellowship of those apostles. Final salvation. No possibility of backsliding anymore. No possibility of suffering anymore. You are saved. You are saved. You are saved forevermore. Are you looking for that time? Are you looking for the coming of the Lord? Tell the Lord, we are saved today. There is a final salvation at that time. There is a final salvation at that time. Unto those that look for him, he shall appear without sin unto the final and the fullness of salvation.